over here in the red. We have the champion of GSL Season 1. He's having a tough time this time around. Can he get to the Final Four? He is the one over. Over here in the top right on our 1-1 map, showing the fruit dealer a tough time. Said he could take him out in this best of five.
And he very may well, Faceless. Very may well, may. I can't speak at all right now. Because I'm actually scared, Tasteless, because I predicted that Nesty and Fruit Dealer would both win today. Really feel that they're both superior players to their opponents, but already Nesty is out via rushes, and now Fruit Dealer is kind of dying to his own one base all-ins. You know? He's doing these one base all-ins. That last game, you did get cannoned in, so it's kind of gross, but still, it's. Makes you wonder.
It does. Spawning pool here for Fruit Dealer. And it looks like Hong and Prime is going to one base.
Yep. And a good choice on this map. Yep. Definitely want to do that. There's some really good warp gate rushes you can do here. But you don't have to play that way. It's a very interesting dynamic map for this matchup.
Well, I'm really curious if we're going to see three warp gate or four warp gate. Or something else totally unexpected.
Yeah. We will see.
Yeah.
Fruit Dealer with another very safe opening, getting that speed upgrade as quickly as possible. Hongan teching up.
Note the positioning here.
Yeah.
This actually makes a small hallway. You can block it with one Zealot.
Indeed you can. Now, a very important thing has just happened. Hongan has taken that second gas. That eliminates the Zealot Stalker Rush, which is a very powerful rush right now that we see a lot on the Korean server.
Hongan moving around with a probe. Looks like he might have wanted to hide a pylon, but he got spotted.
Sees the overlord. He's like, oh, I guess I can't put my stargates over there.
Here comes the hatchery. Pretty soon.
It's like the
intro video. You know how many
calories
you have to eat to become a hatchery or ptosis?
Yeah, a lot,
man.
A lot.
You got to drink a protein shake, you know?
Drones are supposed to be pretty huge, too, right?
Yeah.
So they already need probably, 3,000 calories a day? But actually, aren't they fed by the creep? Pretty sure.
That's true. I think you're right, actually.
Yeah, I think the creep like brings nutrients to Zergs or something. So what if I have Zerglings out in the field for a long time? Do they wither and die?
I don't know. They might be vitamin deficient.
Yeah.
That'd be terrible.
Ooh. Look at this.
Uh-oh.
Now, this could be a few things. It could be a Dark Templar rush. It could be a Blink rush. It could be a Charge rush, but we're going to go ahead and say it's not going to be a Charge rush because
that
build is like ridiculously bad if you know it's coming. But the DT build can be quite good because detection for Zerg comes quite slowly, especially against the Korean style where you get the lair a little bit later. And, the Blink Rush, though, can be very, very strong. We saw Hydra eliminated by Liquid Nazgul at MLG doing that three times in a row.
DTs.
It's going to be the DT, though. And, I wonder what type of DT rush he's going to do. An all-in type, or maybe just a, hey, harass you here, see if I can catch you off guard type. We will see. Turn up some extra gateways.
You know, one thing I'm curious about... is how long is our Zerg going to stay on two hatch and not have a layer? Because
Fruit Dealer gets late layers.
Yeah,
a lot of these Zergs do. Yeah, they love to drone up, get some extra units and stuff like that. But it can be dangerous both against Void Ray rushes and against Dark Templar rushes. So right now, things are looking a bit grim. When we saw the last TT rush we saw off one base against Zerg, I believe, was MC against Nesty, perhaps last season.
Yeah, I think so.
And Nesty just felt it. He was like, I even asked him in the interview, like, how did you have that Overseer? That's a hard thing to do, is Zerg, just to make an Overseer. He's like, you know, it felt like four warp gate, but then it was too long, so I made it. And it looks like Fruit Dealer is going to be eliminated, Tasteless. Right now, we have the Dark Shrine about to finish. And Fruit Dealer has not started a lair.
Oh, God.
He has no evolution chamber. And what is that going up? That is an evolution chamber. So he's starting to feel something. He's like, okay, something's up. But these DTs, you can dance around a lot against them, but they're going to do insanity damage. Completely insanity damage.
You are 100% right. He's moving in there. Zerg can see the blur, but they can't see the DTs.
And he's going to sacrifice every Zergling he has to buy time. Unfortunately, more units are being rallied by Hongan.
The Fruit Dealer suddenly realizes he should have played a little bit safer this time around.
And we have 2-9 kills and a 5 kill.
Uh-oh. Sport Crawler almost done.
Yeah, he's pretty dead, man.
Oh, that's it.
That's about it.
Oh, he's going to get it right before it even finishes. Boom.
And that's...
That's it.
It's going to be that's a GG right there.
Nice timing attack. I think you can see Fruit Dealer probably very frustrated right now.
And in the round of 8 takes us, we're going to lose every single Zerg.
No more Zergs here.
You know, Hongan, good strategy this game. Nice thing to mix in this fifth and final game, a very important game. GG.
GG.
Double equal sign GG. That's a squinted eyes emoticon. Fruit Dealer is not happy. That's what I get out of that.
I wonder why he's not happy, Artosis.
Well, because he's eliminated. A lot of it,
yeah.
I have to say, has to do with him one-basing. It's unfortunate. One of the greatest players in the world. He is out, but Hongan does advance. We do have our first Protoss in the top four of a GSL, and it is Hongan Prime. So I hope you guys left some really good questions, because I will be giving this guy that you see right there, this happy fellow, going to be giving him an interview.
He's got to be so happy to be in the final four. Really awesome, awesome games. I learned a lot casting those. That was a really smart decision for him to go DTs.
Yeah, I liked that build. That was a good choice. No question about
that.
You
know, Fruit Dealer one-based enough that he was like, okay, not this time. I'm going to get my macro going. I'm going to get my economy up. And Hongan, you know, sensed that.
You know, a lot of these top Korean Zergs do not layer quick enough.
No.
To actually block this build. And he took advantage of that.
He did.
That's it. That's the end of the story. I mean.
It's too bad.
You have to get your lair pretty quickly against Protoss. You know, it's a fine line that you walk. If you don't, it's kind of risky. It's almost, you know, they're just trying to abuse for a few extra drones, you know, a little bit more minerals.
It's greedy.
It is. It's greedy.
It's greedy.
And greedy play can be abused, and we see Hongan just did it right there. So props to him on making DTs in that fifth and final game. But I can't help to think about those one base all-ins we saw from Fruit Dealer and that two base all-in that we saw on Scrap Station. Not the best choice.
Kind of sad he's out. No more Zergs.
No more Zergs.
How weird.
It is weird.
I would have thought
a lot
of
Zergs in this tournament.
Win.
And no, I know. Both ex-champions out, but excuse me as I spit all over myself.
I saw it. I wasn't going to say anything.
How sad I am. Luckily, they probably didn't see it because we only broadcasted in 680p.
That's right.
Thank God for that. They'd have some, like, look at Artosis spitting on himself.
He's drooling on himself.
But no, that's it. The Zergs are out. No Zergs into the top four. Normally, both last seasons, we had one Zerg in the top four and three Terrans. But now we have a Terran and a Protoss so far. We're going to have some combinations of Terrans and Protosses from tomorrow. Could see two Terrans and two Protosses. That's kind of what I'm feeling.
Yeah.
Who knows? We'll see.
We're going to find out soon enough. Hope you guys sent in questions for the interview we're going to be doing. You're going to be doing. Let's review today's games.
Both went to the fifth and final game. We saw I'm NST, Season 2 champion, going out to TSL Reign. Then we saw TSL Fruit Dealer, Season 1 champion, going out to Hongan Prime. We both 3-2.
Yeah. GG's. Congrats to Reign and Hongan.
Yeah.
And tomorrow,
we do have Marine King Prime.we against OGS MC. Going to be a very exciting matchup. And then, what you have all been waiting for.
Drum roll.
Liquid Jinro against Choya Foyu, and it is gonna be awesome.
That is true. High chances of us having a Protoss in the finals.
Yeah, high chance of us having a non-Korean player in the top four.
That's true.
Very high chance, I say.
Jinro's very good right now.
He is awesome.
Well,
Jinx, poke poke, you owe me a Coke. A Pepsi, I mean.
A Pepsi. Thank you guys so much for tuning in with us. I'm sorry. I do have a cold. Artosis had the same cold to give it to me. He says it takes a very long time to recover.
Yeah.
But I'm taking care of myself and sleeping a lot. You know, watching a lot of movies. You know, eating my chicken soup. Taking my vitamins. You know?
Chicken soup for the tasteless soul.
Yeah. By the way, as you can see on the bottom of our screen, the finals are going to be held at Incheon. So at 5 p.m.
They are.
Korean Standard Time.
It's 2 hours earlier than you normally tune in. So mark it down on your calendars. Put it on your watch alarm.
Yeah.
It's important.
A little cell phone alarm. Yeah. Like that. Guys, I'll see you tomorrow. Enjoy the interview with Artosis. Much love from Korea. See ya.
It's euphoria out of the blue. Into the light, let it shine down on lonely you. Yeah, you gotta give love.